we can visualize this even a little metaphorically. So for instance, here is, for instance, a mailbox. And suppose that this is address 123. What is in address 123? Well, it's a variable of type int called n. Looks like it's storing the number 50, right? We saw these numbers last week. So here's the number 50, which is an integer inside of this variable, today represented as a mailbox instead of as a locker. Well, suppose that this mailbox over here is not n, but suppose this is p, and it happens to be at address 456, but who really cares? If this variable p is a pointer to an integer, namely that one over there, when I open this door, what am I going to find? Well, I'm hoping I find the equivalent of, I picked these up at the coop earlier, the equivalent of like a conceptual pointer saying the number n is over there. But what specifically, at a lower level, is actually inside this mailbox? If that variable n is at location 0x123, what's probably inside this mailbox? Yeah, the address, indeed, 123. So it's sort of like a treasure map, if you will. Oh, I have to go to 123 to get this value. Oh, the integer in question is indeed 50. And that's the fundamental difference. This is the int that happens to be inside of this variable of type int. This is the address that's a pointer that's in this other variable, p, but that is conceptually simply pointing from one variable to another, thereby giving these sort of conceptual breadcrumbs. And we'll see, frankly,